What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. In this video, I want to show you how you can design vases like this in less than 3 to 5 minutes. So in this tutorial, I want to show you a very easy and quick way on how to create a basic vase setup. Now, from this basic vase setup, I'm also going to show you how to make vases out of curves, and then show you how easy it is to use modifiers to create unlimited possibility of vases, and then a very basic mesh cleanup and prep for 3D printing. So let's start with the very basics. Using our starter cube, let's go into edit mode, select everything, and merge this down into one vertex. This vertex is our primary center point where we're going to be extruding out, putting out maybe a good 5 centimeters out, which means we now have this here. And then let's just use this as a very simple vase example. So let's just go a little bit out this way and then up there. So this here already gives us the profile of a very simple vase. Now the main modifier we're going to be using to make this work is the screw modifier. Using the screw modifier, turning off smooth shading and merging all vertices, this now gives us a nice simple little shape here, and you can change the steps right here. So if you want, you can make it really smooth or not so smooth. So you can play around there. I'm gonna go for something maybe, I don't know, 8. And then from this point here, you can almost already turn this into something that can be 3D printed. So in fact, you could apply this, then let's go back into the edit mode, select that top edge, hit F, and this is already 3D printable in vase mode. So you could select this, hit 3D print using the 3D print toolbox, and export this out for 3D printing. That there is the very basic setup of vase creation in Blender. However, I would like to show you how to make a lot more complicated and organic looking vases really easily using curves and modifiers. So let's jump straight into that. So working with our basic mesh vase, let's go and explore curves. So I'm just gonna turn off this screw modifier so we get an understanding that this here is just a vertex to a vertex, so it's a vertex line. So selecting this, we can convert this into a curve. What this lets us do that in edit mode, we can now select what we're wanting and change the spline type to a Bezier. This now lets us literally curve our vase. So if we go and add our screw modifier right now, you can see that we have a live edit of what we're creating here. Now you can see that it's quite segmented, which might be what you're looking for, but if it isn't, you have to go into your curve modifier data here, which lets you increase the resolution to create it very smooth if you want. Now, once you have something that you quite like the look of, you're going to have to turn it back into a mesh to be able to 3D print it. So up here, you can see that this is a little line. That means that it's a curve. So when we're back in object mode, having the curve selected, you can convert this curve object back into a mesh. See, now it's a triangle. So using that exact same thing, let's select that top layer, fill it up, and that is now 3D printable in vase mode. Now onto the unlimited possibilities that is modifiers. I'm gonna try and keep this quite concise, but I'll do my best because there's a lot to cover here. So modifiers let you do a lot once you have something like this. One of the most favorite ones is probably subdivision. This lets you really smooth out things using this viewport subdivide. As you see, you get quite a nasty base, but I'll show you how to deal with that later on. If you're not too happy with how that's looking up top, you can do this subdivision curve while the top is still open.
and then applying the subdivision will give you that very nice smooth surface as well. Now, another one that's quite fun to play around with is the decimate one. This is one of my favorite because it gives you this low poly feel. So once you get close here, you get this really interesting shapes forming up. Another modifier that's quite interesting is triangulate. Now, triangulate won't do much on its own because what you see here is once you apply triangulation, in the edit mode, you have all these new lines. Now, this changes the calculation of many of the modifiers. So if we go and undo that triangulate, and then we apply that decimate as well, because we have this triangulation beforehand, you'll see how different the shape is. So I'm going to turn off this triangulate. You can see we have quite a change there. So that's one of the ones that I use to just change the regular shape into something a little bit more irregular. Now, working with this, there's another one that works very nicely in conjunction once you have something quite low poly. So I'm just going to apply these down for now, is wireframe. So wireframe gives you this feel of a framing like this. Now, you can see we have an open surface up at the top here, which will give us quite a bit of problems later on. So let's just quickly, in edit mode, add and close this up, and that closes up the wireframe here. So this technically is 3D printable from right this point here just by applying it. And lastly, one more that's pretty decent on its own is solidify. So if you're wanting to really create a sturdy vase out of this, you know that vase mode isn't really going to cut it unless you have a very thick nozzle on your 3D printer. So let's go ahead and figure out how to use the solidify command to give you something really usable. So if you hit solidify, this increases the thickness of the wall. As you've seen, that expanded it outwards when it was -1. So that means that currently our normals are flipped. So let's just quickly select everything, do here and do recalculate normals. That flips it now inwards because it is on a -1 here. So if you're wanting this to offset from the surface using both going 0.5 one way and 0.5 the other way, I mean 1.5 because we're doing 3 millimeters. So this here dictates the thickness. So let's go for something crazy like 5. If you're wanting this to be inwards, you go -. If you want this to be outwards, you go +. Okay, lastly, I want to just touch that you can really play about adding these two together. So for instance, going back to that wireframe, if we go and close this object up once again so that our wireframe works nice and friendly with us, we're going to add a wireframe. Let's give this 5 millimeters. But if you want to get something really crazy, you add a subdivision after that wireframe. And look how easy it is to get something that would be incredibly difficult to model right here, almost ready to print from this point. Now, one last example is subdivision. So let's go ahead and open this back up. So we already have a decimate placed on this mesh. So if we just go and subdivide this mesh right now, this gives us a completely different look to our vase. Now, working from here, lastly, 3D printers really do like having some clean geometry to work with. So let's first start by cleaning up this geometry. The first thing I look at is I go into the item properties and make sure that the scale is all set to 1, as well as the size and dimensions that I like, so then I make sure that I'm exporting a file that's going to work for my needs that I'm going to need on my 3D printer. Once I've done that, I usually go ahead and I'm going to close this top now. But before I close this top, you're going to have to see that sometimes closing the top would not be the best idea because we still have this subdivision. So this can change from different outcome to outcome. So I'm going to apply this modifier now to then close my lid here, because my plan is to print this out in vase mode. So now with that closed there, we still have the issue of our bottom. This is not a lot of surface area. So lastly, let's go and make sure that this is 3D printable and make sure that it is flat. So I'm first going to go ahead and sort out the flatness. There's two ways of going about this. My favorite way is going into edit mode, selecting the faces that I want to be the bottom. So let's select a good variety here. And then I'm going to scale this, but instead of scaling like that, I'm going to restrict it to the Z axis and just hit 0. And right there, we get a really nice, clean, flat surface to work with. Alternatively, you can go ahead and do something called a bool cut. So let's create a cube to work with here. So let's create this cube, a nice big cube. Let's go for a nice 10 centimeters there. Open this up. Now, because we just scaled that up, we've got to apply the transforms. Oh, I did this in edit mode, so excuse me for that. Let's go out of edit mode to make sure we're making this as an individual object. And then let's scale it up a bit. Let's apply all the transforms to this. Now, just looking at it from the front, let's move this down to, let's say we wanted to cut it right there. Actually, no, let's go right up here somewhere. Let's say we only wanted that top part. So to do this, I use, there's this bool tool in the plugins. So I'm going to select this, and then I'm going to select my vase. Then I'm going to use my edit bool tool, union difference. And that straight away gives me a nice flat bottom to work with. Now, lastly, to check that this is 3D printable, I go into edit mode. I'm just going to select everything, and I'm going to use the 3D print toolbox. Again, this is another add-on, and I'm going to check it all out and see what we've got going on here. So we've got some non-flat faces. So the reason why we have non-flat faces is because there's too many. This is not a quad, it's a 5-point. So what we're going to do is select everything, or instead of selecting everything, we select just the non-flat faces. Going to clean up, we're going to distort it. And that there, when we do a check all again, has removed that. Now it's saying that there's overhang faces, but there isn't really, because what it's telling us is that the base here is overhanging, but we know that that's the base. So working with this here, we can now export it out. And that there is a 3D printed vase. Well, it might not be a 3D printed vase. It's a sculpture of some sort, but you can get really creative. So I'm going to show you a couple of examples of things that I've both 3D printed and already modeled out to 3D print in the future.
Now you know the incredible power of Blender and vase creation. A big thank you to my Patreon supporters over there. They're going to get these files forever for free. And if you're interested in this, these files will be free down in the description for the next 3 months of when this video comes out. So one thing I want to mention just before we go forward and out of this video is that when you're creating these, don't be stuck in the 2D front view like I was. If you go out of that front view before you do your screw, you can create some incredible shapes. Anyway, thanks for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.